Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. For anyone who's new here, hi, I'm Jane. And we cover beauty, skincare, a little bit of lifestyle and wellness on this channel. So if that sounds like a bit of you, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button. It really helps me out. So today's video or vlog is not going to be a very long one. I am currently going through an MS relapse, so they're always a little bit different. What classes as a relapse is basically when you have a new symptom that lasts more than 24 hours. My new symptom, sorry, I've had probably for certainly going on 2 months now, so definitely longer than 24 hours. My new symptom is excruciating pain in the arch of my foot. I've been to my doctors, I've had an x-ray, I've seen a podiatrist, and there's basically nothing wrong with my foot. It's nerve pain, and it's false nerve pain caused by probably a new lesion in my spine. And or in my brain. And it's basically sending a message to the nerves in that area of my foot that I'm injured, that there's an injury there. So I've got the pain of having a very unpleasant injury, but there's actually nothing to show for it other than the pain. So it's making it very difficult to walk, very uncomfortable, but it hurts no matter what I do. It's hurting. I'm sat on the sofa at the minute and it hurts. It almost feels like a really, really bad bruise to really bad cramping that I can't stretch out. And it just almost spasms in this cramp. It's not very nice. But the relapse has also sort of brought back a couple of symptoms I've had in the past that just sort of, they're not, thankfully, they're not full force. That's the pain's enough of that. But the ones that I'm getting at the minute is blurred vision. So I can't focus very well. A bit of mild vertigo, so lightheaded, dizzy, as if I've had maybe one too many. And I promise you, I haven't been drinking. I'm not safe. I don't feel safe to drive, so I'm not driving at the moment. So I'm currently off work, which is really frustrating. I always feel really useless when I'm in this situation, because it's there's nothing I can do about it. And it is very frustrating, because I want to be at work, I want to go shopping, I want to be able to drive places and things like that, and MS takes that away from me. Thankfully, not all the time, but more often than I would like. And any time is more often than I would like. So yes, I have an appointment with my neurologist towards the end of this month, and hopefully there might be unfortunately a medication, because I don't like taking I don't like taking paracetamol at the best of times, let alone any other medication. But in this instance, this chronic foot pain that's been over 2 months now, enough's enough. it's debilitating, and it wears you out being in constant pain. Anyone who suffers with constant pain will tell you how tiring it is. I sometimes think if the pain was somewhere other than the sole of my foot, I could maybe be getting on with things a bit better. But because it's in my foot and the sole of my foot, it affects walking, standing, you know, anything that you take for granted. And as I said, the pain I'm going through, it happens, it's constant. And then the sort of cramp, excuse me, I've got a runny nose, the cramp type spasms I'm having, they'll happen in the middle of the night, they happen when I've got my feet up on the sofa, they happened when I was swimming. I've had to cut back on the swimming for now because, as I said, I'm not driving. And I used to walk to the leisure centre, but I'm not able to do that at the minute. And I want to be keeping fit and keeping up with my exercises and going on the long dog walks, going to the gym, going, you know, all of these things I want to do. But my body's going, no. Not right now. I did manage to complete the 50 squats a day for the charity Mind. I did complete that, so I was really, really thankful that I managed to get through with doing that. I carried on doing them because, as I said, my foot hurts no matter what I'm doing. It hurts if I'm doing nothing, and it hurts if I'm doing something. So I decided to just carry on with them. And I am trying to carry on with certain things, but I'm having to take a break more often, which I don't like. I get thoroughly pissed off, I'll be honest. Sorry for the language. But it's so frustrating because my mind is... Why aren't you working? Why aren't you doing that? Why aren't you working on earning money from home and things that like that, which I could be doing, and I am doing, in all honesty. But my body is fighting against me at the moment, and that's kind of, to me, a bit like what MS basically is. Your mind's like... Yeah, I want to do something, and your body laughs and says, no doing something. You did something a week ago, and that's enough doing somethings. And sometimes I wish my body would just do one. I know that's like stupid, but yeah, so that's where we are at the minute. Funnily enough, my mental health is actually doing quite well at the moment, which I suppose in a way it's got something else to concentrate on. So yeah, I'm actually doing really well now, thankfully. With the mental health side, so that's great. I just the other health is not in the best way at the moment. But when you live with a chronic illness, and for me, MS is the one I have, you don't get used to things, but you get to the point where that's life. And you can go down the dark side. And I feel for anyone who does go that way or at points goes that way, because I've been there and it's horrible. But we don't do it intentionally. It is one of those things, unfortunately. But for me, I do try and stay as upbeat as I can, because I don't like being miserable. I'm a happy person. I've always been a happy person. Anyone who knows me will say, you know there's something seriously wrong if I'm not happy, because that's just not who I am. But, you know, I'm still happy. It's my husband's birthday tomorrow, so I'm going to attempt to make him a birthday cake. I'll do it in bits so that I'm not standing constantly, even though most of the time I'm stood on one leg anyway, which isn't brilliant for my posture, but we work with what we've got. So yes, that's my plans for this afternoon, is I'm going to make him a birthday cake. He loves apple cake, so I'll see if I can make him an apple cake, but we'll see. But apart from that, I'm doing very little at the minute. I'm doing quite a bit of research on ways of earning money online. I think they're known as side hustles. So if anyone's got any suggestions, anything I can have a look at, give me a shout. But that's where I am. So I'm sorry if the videos today it's obviously just a very sit down talky one. But it is my life. And I like to be upfront and honest with you all. And this is where I am at the moment. So unfortunately, I couldn't take you on a day out or things like that. But we will. We have a new vehicle coming. So I think it's predominantly, it's my daughter's, but I will have use of it. I'm actually quite excited about it. It's an automatic, which means that when my right leg is playing up, because it's usually my right leg, which has always stopped me from driving in the past, being automatic, that won't have a problem now. It's just obviously when with the vision is what will stop me from driving it. And at the minute, that is why I am not. But yeah, I'm looking forward to that, even as a passenger. So I will show you around that when that arrives, maybe next week. But there we are. I will not keep you any longer. Thank you if you're still here after this, for the length of this video. Thank you for sticking with me. I will keep you informed, hopefully. As I said, my neurologist appointment's in about 2 weeks' time. I'll let you know how that goes, and I'll see you next time. Bye.